Hey guys, this is David Kwan, and today I'm going to reveal to guys and to a public what I normally don't tell anyone that I know in real life, unless I'm really close friends with them, or unless they're really close to me, then they will know what today is for me. But, you know, because you can go to my Facebook profile, and, you know, even if you're not my friend, most of information about me is pretty public. You can go on there and see my job history. You can see on there and see some pictures of me. It's not private locked or anything. So it's a very transparent page, but one information you're not gonna find on my Facebook is my birthday. And you know, I don't know why, but that's just something I normally have not ever disclosed to really anyone. I guess part of it is just because it's not a day that I really consider that important. It's my birthday, but so what? It's just the day I was born, and I get a year older. Never really, you know, considered a big deal, but I do always enjoy celebrating it with people who are really close to me. My parents certainly know what day today is, so I got an email from my mom and dad. But yeah, today I turned 26. So now I'm just revealing out to all public, so anybody who watches this now knows that my birthday is today. And I turned 26. That number seems huge in some respects. I still feel like a really young kid. Especially considering how this year was, I feel like a teenager who just is about to enter college again, and who just, you know, fled away from my parents' home and landed on this strange new land called New York City, and waiting to start college. I still feel like an 18-year-old, but no, I'm actually, and I look like an 18-year-old. I know, I get that a lot. If I buy an M-rated video game at GameStop, I still get carded. That's ridiculous, because the age limit for an M-rated game is 17. I don't look older than 17 to some people. That's crazy, but no, I'm 26 now, and comparing, you know, the life circumstances of the people I know in real life, 26 seems like a huge number. Most of the people I know in high school or have known from high school, they're like, you know, they're usually a year younger than me, because I did get held back in third grade when I immigrated to America. So I repeated third grade or 6 months of third grade. So I'm usually a year older than most of the people I have gone to high school or gone to college with. And so most of the people I know in high school are at this point 25, or some people have, if their birthday is later than me, they're just about to turn 25. So, you know, I'm older than them usually, not always, but usually. But I look at, like, my, you know, the people I know, a lot of them are not like my friends per se, but I was friends with them, or they're good acquaintances, people I know. A lot of them are married already. And that's a surprising thing to know that most of the people that I've gone to high school with, they're married. Most of them have a son or a daughter. They have a kid. And some of them even have multiple sons and daughters. That feels weird, because I still feel like a kid. And I still feel so immature sometimes. I mean, I made that video about having to do laundry, and it's so annoying. I don't want to do it. I don't want to do this adult responsibility. Having to pay rent and living on my own. This is not what I signed up for, but I mean, I appreciate it because I do have a lot of freedom and independence. I love that. And, you know, I'm not the type of person to get homesick. So I'm you know, thousand miles away from my parents, but I don't really get homesick. I don't have a problem with that. I mean, I do sometimes miss them, like, every once or twice a year. But I'm pretty, you know, I don't get homesick. But I guess the problem is, I still feel like a teenager who's not doing much. I'm currently unemployed. I'm just volunteering regularly at this nonprofit organization. And I'm just waiting till September. Because September, I start grad school. So, and I still have 2 years of schooling to go to get an MSW. So it's just waiting, and just chilling. And my closest friend is in Japan, and he's gonna be in there for until July-ish or maybe August. So don't really, I can't really get to hang out with him. My closest friends from high school are still in California, or I think they moved to a different state, but that's not New York. And my really close friend who we were co-workers, but now she's a really close friend, she's currently not in New York. She went on a trip to a totally different country. And she'll be back, and we'll probably celebrate my birthday after she returns, because she would be one of those people I tell, I already told, when my birthday is, and we'll just hang out. And before she went on this trip, we celebrated her birthday, because her birthday's in April. So yeah, I mean, it just feels weird to be at this age, 26. I felt like 25 would be that age when I would feel like a super adult, and in some ways I did, because in at least in America and many states, 25 is the age where you can be a if someone has a driver's permit, but not a license, and they need to drive, as long as a 25-year-old or older person is in the passenger seat next to them, they can drive with that driver's permit. So it's just like, wow, 25, I get to be a chaperone in the car. That's like the official age for like super adult. Although, I mean, 21 is the age for adult, to many people. Or all depending on what you're talking about, I guess in the foster care system, 18 is the age for adult, which I feel like that's way too young, but that's when they age out. But 21 is considered as adult because that's like the age when you can smoke. Oh, that's the age when you can drink in this country. I know in some European countries you get to drink much younger than that. And in Korea, 21 is the age you can actually, that's the age you can legally drive. Driving age in Korea is really late. That's pretty ridiculous. But yeah, 26, just this is just me mumbling on. And I'm not doing much of anything today. I've been really sick since yesterday. I'm still sick. I have a nasty case of flu. I can't remember the last time I was this sick. It must have been years. My nose is very, my face is kind of redder than usual, which is not that much red, but it's still redder than usual to me. My voice is kind of raspy, and sometimes it hurts to talk. I'm sniffling, and of course, it's just I have a case of a either common cold or some kind of flu. Feels miserable, really. I really don't want to go out anywhere and do anything today. So I'm just here. I called out for my volunteering, so I'm just staying home, hoping that my immune system fights this out and I get better for it. But I do feel really fortunate that I don't get sick that often, and it's just a cold. I can't imagine the actual horror of an actual life-threatening illness like malaria or pneumonia or anything like that. I've never experienced something like that ever before in my life. And I guess it's a fortunate thing, but I just that must be a horrible thing, the horror of that, because I know, I don't know. But right now I just have a common cold, I'm sick, I turned 26, and just making this video to tell you about all that. And so yeah, I think that's this random video is over now. So thank you for watching and may pot potentially having wasted 9 minutes of your life, but hopefully you don't consider it that way. You just watch me talk to you. All right, cheers.